In Drupal 8, people are handled separately from content types such as events or news. On the front page, a random selection of people from your site are shown under People directory. To see the full list, I'm going to use the View directory link. This brings us to a page displaying all the people on our site, separated out by their appointments, such as chair, faculty, or staff. We also have access to filter options on the side that can be used to pare down the list. And these can be customized based on your specific site's needs. To add or edit people, I'm going to click on the People tab in the Administrative toolbar. This brings me to another list of people on the site, and this time we have access to convenient edit buttons next to each person. You can also filter this list by things such as name or role. To add a new user, you'll either be using the blue Add User button on this page, or if you hover over people, you can click on the Add a New User dropdown. My boss has sent me some information on a new faculty member that needs a profile, so let's check it out. And it looks like I have an image and some text. So let's start with the text. So it looks like we have all the information here we need to get started, so let's head back to the site. So I'm going to add in their name. So this was Kristen Kirk, and their name.number was Kirk.31330. In terms of pictures, you have two options. You can either upload an image, or you can use their OPIC image, if you know the person has an OPIC. Right now, I know this person doesn't have an OPIC image, so I'm just going to choose File, and upload their image. Since I upload the image, I'm going to need to provide alternative text or a short description of the image used by screen readers and displayed when the image is not loaded. And since this is just a person, it's going to be their name, so Kristen Kirk. Scrolling down, I can fill in their email as kirk.31330@osu.edu. And if they have a separate email address that they're using, such as an @math.osu.edu or some other type of professional email, you can put that here instead. For the username, though, I always want to make it their name.number@osu.edu email address. So this one has to be the name.number@osu.edu email address. And this is because otherwise the OSU single sign-on system, where they can use their name.number and password for any OSU site, will not work otherwise. So please remember to always put this as the name.number@osu.edu email address. Now under here, you'll see a password field. And this is because how people normally work under Drupal would be they would each have their own unique password. Since OSU is using its own single sign-on solution, this isn't necessarily something that you're going to be using later, but it is required by Drupal. So what I like to do is make a random string of letters and numbers, so something like this, copy that, and paste into the password fields. And then this provides Drupal with its password, but then the user can use their own name.number and password later. Under that, we have the status of blocked or active, and obviously we want this person to be active. If they leave the university, we will switch this to blocked. For assignable roles, I always want to assign them unit faculty and staff, and this makes sure that they will show up on the website itself. For users like myself or the other ASC Tech Web Services members, we will not have this, and so we will have accounts on your site, but they won't show up in the directory. So I'm going to check that off for her. And then I'm also going to check off profile user, and this is because this allows the person to actually edit their own profile. And not every site needs this, not every site wants it, but if you need or want the user to actually be able to edit their own profile, add in information as it becomes available later, they can do it if you have this assigned role to them. I'm going to skip over notifying the user of their new account, and this is because I think it's better to actually email them yourself instead of an automatic Drupal email coming in. After that, we've got the bio field. So I have just a little bit of placeholder text here, but obviously either they can change this later or I could have put in a different bio. And I'm going to copy and paste this. And again, you might see this pop up here that says the text you paste seems to be copied from Word. Do you want to clean it up? And you always want to hit OK. And this is because Word can add in extra code that can really mess with the Drupal website. So I'm just going to hit OK and let it clean. You may notice a few extra spaces like right here. So I'm just going to go in and remove that manually. But that's a product of the conversion process. And underneath, I'm going to set their appointment to core faculty. And their job title was professor. And then I believe we had a few areas of expertise, so communication, design, marketing. I'm going to fill that in here. So communication, add another item, design, and marketing. We had a few education fields, and so it looks like they have a couple here, so I'm just going to copy and paste these ones over so I don't have to retype them out. You may notice that I brought over a bullet point accidentally, so sometimes that also happens when copying and pasting from Word, so I'm just going to get rid of these. And the final one. Let's get rid of that. After that, your site may have research interests, and this is a taxonomy that you can set up with ASE web services beforehand. Obviously, it's not required. Right here, we just have a few examples. I'm just going to click a few so it'll show up later. We can put in the professional website. I'm just going to put in an example address at the moment. You can either Twitter, YouTube, or LinkedIn accounts. For the contact information, obviously, we want their phone number, so 614-555-5555. The address, now, the address came on one line here, but it's probably a little nicer to actually put it all on their own lines, so I'm just going to do that really quick. And then for office hours, it looked like it was 2 o'clock p.m. to 4 o'clock p.m., Monday, Wednesday, Friday, so that's just fine. So we had a little bit of a mishap with the special characters here. And I'm going to hit create new account. Now it's going to reload the form, but at the top it'll actually put a message that said a new user has been created for kirk31330@osu.edu. And now if I actually click on this link, I can see their profile. So we have all the information I just put in. And if I go out to the people page, Kristen will be showing up under core faculty. Example of the filters not in action right here, the research interests. And all the way out in the front, we have Kristen showing up under our random selection of people. Now that we've completed this topic, choose the next video on the right side of the screen. Review the entire playlist with the link on the left.